Have you ever watched an anime that took the business world, or since this is Japan, salaryman culture, and gave it a shonen twist? Neither have I, and that's why I'm here to break down Kigyou Senshi Yamazaki, Long Distance Call. From the first scene of the OVA, I knew I was going to feel this because of that main character zipping across buildings like a Super Saiyan. It actually was pretty bizarre. Until I sat through the anime and realized that 60% of it is dialogue, literally after that first scene until maybe the last 15 minutes or so. But let's talk about it. The anime is centered around the strongest businessman, an android that was built by, literally as described in the anime, temporary staffing agencies. His name is Business Fighter, and he's made from... Well, why don't I let the anime just tell you itself? I actually found his concept to be gold, as it basically makes an action story out of how business politics usually go. Which in the real world, we see things to be very professional and passive and, of course, legal. This is a semi-futuristic twist on the modern era of the time it came out in. The anime came out in 1997. It wasn't exactly elaborated on, but from a brief conversation two men had at a bar in the anime, in this post-war Japan, the government created the contemporary society of working class people, as opposed to nature and society naturally just doing its thing, like in our world. This guy is a maniac though. He's a straight business shark and is always thinking ahead and trying to innovate in the company. Actually, this is majority of the OVA. The problem that we constantly see is stress leads him to having these random spikes where he'll like grab his head and you'll see his eyes turn red or whatever the case may be, or maybe that's just the way it was animated or styled, but this causes him to have to go see his engineer because he's taking on too much stress, the way a regular human would have to go to the doctor from taking in too much stress. It seems like after every job he does, it leads him in need of maintenance. One thing I'll speak on too is this weird, I don't know if it's supposed to be subtle romantic, but there's also this delinquent teenage girl that he picks up and saves from a drunk on the street earlier on in the anime. And she kind of just keeps popping up, and they try to accessorize her to him as like a human being side to the story, if she even is a human. But I kind of felt like she was more in the way, and what they were trying to do, it really didn't fit. She would at times have emotional outbursts and try to talk deep with him. And even though they did speak to one another on their backgrounds, I didn't really buy into what they were trying to do. So when you watch this, just expect that. Now, maybe you've seen it or maybe you'll go watch it and you'll understand what's going on. So come back and leave a comment and tell me what it is. Unfortunately, or maybe this may be intriguing for some, there is a lot of actual business convos and jargon going on here. You see actual boardroom meetings go down and see graphs and percentages and discussions on marketing tactics and stuff, which leads to the stuff that we want eventually, but it's pretty interesting to see as it's building up. Still a grown man anime. They even start talking about things that are like elementary school ideas by today's standards, like developing phones that could be communicated through without physically picking them up, and phones the size of a credit card, which we're pretty much almost there in today's world. All that action stuff I mentioned at the beginning comes in at the last 10 to 15 minutes before you probably get bored. And then it really does its thing. It kind of has that sci-fi meets DBZ or anything 90s shonen down the middle. Actually, it kind of reminded me of Battle Angel Alita with the whole cyborg thing. But then Yamazaki will even name call his attacks like how shonen would do at that time. All this doesn't last very long, but it was worth the wait considering this was only 43 minutes. Now, I didn't pick up on the whole human-android symbolism that we usually see where it makes you wonder if a robot can have emotions or whatever. Even though certain things suggest this, when he's literally told to get rid of his emotions because he's a machine, but the OVA doesn't really posterize this as much as others do. Yamazaki tends to be pretty closed and cutthroat a lot of the time. As far as the whole android and human thing go, there's a twist somewhere towards the end that makes more sense of how they relate to each other historically, with brain transplants and rebirth. Especially anecdotal to Yamazaki, it's the whole beyond the grave kind of thing. But go watch the show. Believe it or not, this adaptation was sourced by a 12-volume manga, which is another testament to how much anime and manga we have to uncover over our journeys as fans. So many things barely made it out of Japan. All the production stuff we usually talk about, though, are forgettable. That's the art, music, the animation. I mean, there was a couple of soundtracks that kind of stood out a little bit, but for the most part, they were after behind thoughts. Yeah, in that regard, it's all kind of fly by night, but you know, it's still watchable and enjoyable. The 80s and 90s was a unique time in the medium because it seemed to be the last time where there was a hearty quantity and specific pool dedicated to anime for grown men, which featured grown men engaging in grown men activities. As we get older, if we want to keep watching this stuff and enjoy it, at some point we will start seeking these elements out. And that's what I feel like people who alienate older anime miss out on, because this is most definitely one of the ones palatable to a mature audience. I mean, this dude is 42 years old. Like the video, comment down below what y'all want to see next. I'm out. Thanks for watching. Anime Back When.